Opposition legislators started their day with a caucus meeting in the boardroom of the leader of opposition, stretched beyond lunchtime. As the House sitting started a few minutes past 2 p.m., they started powering into the chambers where they have been missing for over a month. The Kira Municipality legislator, Ibrahim Ssemujju Nganda, straight away requested the speaker to amend the order paper to prioritize the statement, which was number 6 on the list.
Those of us who have not been coming here, we have millions of people that we represent here. Their expectation is that a matter of this magnitude will actually persuade you to give it priority. So the procedure accompanied with the request, Madam Speaker, is that you vary the order paper like you have done in many other instances before.
And since you said you want it to be brought before issues of netball, I will move it before netball. That is okay.
However, the minister in charge was nowhere to be seen at the time of the statement, forcing the opposition to move a motion seeking suspension of the House for 15 minutes, but it flopped in a vote by the House.
Much obliged, Right Honorable Speaker. As I came in, I phoned my brother, the Honorable Ssemujju, making a very passionate plea to you to allow for this matter to be given a priority. And for the reasons you have more than any other person fully appreciated, and we appreciate you for that understanding. Honorable Speaker, because of the gravity of this subject,
Honorable, just a minute, love. Government, where is the Minister of...
Right Honorable Speaker, the Minister is on his way coming.
Government later presented the long-awaited statement through the Minister of State for Internal Affairs, Gen. David Mohozi, dismissing some opposition claims of human rights violations.
These false and mendacious claims against government are unfortunately sometimes believed by those in the host countries who are gullible to take these claims as true without verification. Others still sometimes are fugitives from justice. For example, the suspects who had evaded appearing in court for assaulting a one Kamuntu Ivan, Elias Majambere, were aided to leave the country. The next of kin of the reported missing persons, first of all, didn't cooperate with the police investigators until the police team had to hold out as members of an NGO in order to interview these people. For example, Nabakoza Florence, the next of kin of Wangolo Dennis, alias Shafiq, declined to meet the investigators, stating that she had not got instructions from NUP to meet any person.
On accountability of lives lost during the November 2020 riots, the government says that some victims perished in motor accidents caused by rioters.
56 people lost their lives, including those by gunshot wounds and others whose death were through other causes incidental to the riots.
However, the opposition asked for more time to digest the government statement and bounce back with a rejoinder next week.
Right Honourable Speaker, I would like to appreciate the Honourable Minister of State for Internal Affairs' consideration that we make a rejoinder so that we can make good sense out of this 17-page document authored across 40 days. So, I give it to pray.
Thank you. Honourable Members, the report came a little late, and we expect a rejoinder from the opposition. And it's just prudent enough that we give the leader of opposition to bring his rejoinder on Tuesday.
Meanwhile, some opposition legislators have dismissed the government response, saying it lacks substantial answers to questions of human rights concerns at hand.
The frivolousness of the statement is all there for everyone to see. I was only short of raising a motion to reject it, but I thought it, after consulting my team, that we are better off threading it by responding to it with a rejoinder next week.
Is that they were unable to come to the bottom. So this was an admission that they have failed to find facts about the missing persons. And we will, as the leader of opposition said, be making a response. Because how can you be a government and then you say I failed to come to the bottom? Because with all the agencies, even if the families were not cooperative, government has many other ways of finding people.
The opposition say their boycott is still arriving up to Tuesday when they plan to resume normal business. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.